y'all know that. I'm a jet. You can play pastor, you can play deacon, you can play me, but you can't play God. Y'all gotta understand, if you love me, it's gonna show up sooner or later. But if you really don't love me, I'm gonna know after a while, because you can't put up for so long. It's for the real you. Y'all help me a little bit here. God wants you to understand something, that tonight in this love factor, God wants you to know, I love you. But I need to know, do you really love me? God says something. He gives an exhortation. It starts out in this chapter by God telling us we ought to be one if we got the same spirit. So if we got the same spirit, we ought to be able to know God. And God ought to know us. And then he goes on to start picking up in verse 7, where he starts talking, beloved, let us love one another. It's important that we love. The exhortation is, beloved, let us love one another. God want to know if you love your brother. See, it's a horizontal thing, must be right first before the vertical stuff gets in order. I got to be able to look across at somebody and know that I love them before I can look up and tell God I love him. I've got to work the horizontal in order to get the vertical right. God says in Matthew, he says, before you come to the altar and get vertical, make sure you go back and get your stuff right with your brother. He said, leave your gift right here and go and get it right with your brother. Then come on back here. In other words, get it right horizontally. And then you can start talking about how much you talk about you loving me and you treat me any kind of way. Talk about you love God and treat your mate any kind of way. I wish I had a little help in here. Talk about you love God and you can't even buy your wife a nice dress or suit, and then you tell me you love God. God said in Ephesians 5, he tells us, he said, love, husbands, love your wife as Christ loved the church. He loved the church so much that he died for the church. I always tell in my premarital counseling, I always ask this question to couples. I look at the groom and I say, what you die for? Some of them. I ain't talking about all of them. Maybe some of them girls, they just say, they get thinking about that thing. And I said, yes, I said, would you die for them? I want you to know I've had to put off a few wedding engagements until they could answer that question, because there's no sense in me going any further if you can't answer that question in the affirmative. And ladies, don't be sympathetic, don't be compassionate. If the Negro can't say yes, then you ought to call it off. Come on, somebody in here, talk to me, somebody. Don't wait until you get in a trouble situation. Don't wait till you get in the test and find out that he didn't love you as much as he do. If you can't answer the question right then, he ain't gonna answer it at all the way you want it. Don't blame yourself. The exhortation said, beloved, let us love one another. Yeah, that's what he said in verse 7. And then in 7b, he said, there's got to be a demonstration. You just can't tell me, yeah, and that's it. You just can't tell me, yeah, I do, and then there's nothing manifested. For he says in 7b, he said, if you love me. Y'all talk to me in here. He said there ought to be a presence of love. Yeah. In your life that demonstrates that you know God. Yeah, that's what it says. He said, because if you know God, how you know love. It said, everyone that loveth is born of God. It didn't say that you were born in love. It means you were born of God. And what does that mean? Nicodemus told us about that in John 3. And he asked the question, how can a man be born again? Can he enter into his mother's womb a second time? Jesus said, no, this kind of birth is born with spirit and water. Can I get some help in here? I tell you today, you got to be born again. To love like you ought to love, you got to be born again. You can't stay in mess. Can I get some help? Unless you're born again. You can't put up with mess unless you've been born again. You can't stay there when everybody's telling you to leave unless you've been born again. You can't continue to pour out when everybody's shutting up on you unless you're born again. You can't keep walking in here telling God thank you unless you've been born again. That I know God. Y'all with me? Yeah, that's the test. I got the presence of love in one life demonstrate that he knows God. You can't mess around here and get hooked up with somebody and they constantly demonstrate evilness and unrighteousness. And then go talk about I'm going to pray it out of them. It's Valentine. Yeah. You what is it? See, y'all act like you don't know what I'm talking about. But I'm talking about those folk that mess around and unheard. I love you for 9 months. But ain't never seen no God in the person. And said, well, when I get him. Y'all are talking to me. When I get him, I'm going to make him all right. I'm going to spend a few hours on my knees. Can I get some help in here? But I got news for you. The Bible said, don't be unequally. If he ain't saved before you marry, he ain't going to be saved after you. Don't mess around here and change it. Got news for you, you ain't changing nobody. If God don't change you, it ain't gonna be changed. Pray all you want, fast all you want, but unless God changes you, they gonna keep on being the hell that they always be. There needs to be a demonstration of presence of God needs to be in a person. Then you ought to see some God in them somewhere. All you see is evil stuff. And then you won't talk about, you won't hope they're going to turn around. The word says here, he said one, and everyone that loveth is born of God and knoweth God. So they ought to show some presence of God in their walk. And then he says in verse 8, he says, the failure of a person to exhibit love in his life demonstrate that he doesn't know God. Come on, talk to me somebody. When there's a failure of a person to exhibit love in his life, And preacher done told me what I ought to do. And what they ought to do. When I come in with the word that day, can I get some help? And start telling her, come on, come on. The pastor said, in the book of Ephesians, that you ought to love your wife as Christ loved the church. In verse 8, he says, he that loveth not, knoweth not God. For God is what? And then look what he says. He picks up in verse 9. He says, and then this was manifested. In other words, that was evidence. Y'all ought to talk to me. You know, everything that if you love me, ought to be some manifestation. You know, I don't mind a look. It's all right, but someday y'all want to talk to me sometimes. Sometimes I don't mind a glance, but sometimes I want a hug, dude. Y'all ain't talking to me here. And you know what I'm talking about. Ain't you? Yeah. Every now and then you gotta have some manifestation of that love. Somebody come home with you. Show some joy, some peace, love.